before sounds were recorded onto vinyl records, and even before they were recorded onto shellac records, that they were put onto wax cylinders. Here is how look a wax cylinder produced industrially at the very beginning of 20th century. Cylinder collections are very rare. The library at UCC has a beautiful set of 114 cylinders. Some of them are broken, unfortunately, but most of them are in fair to good condition. So I'm invited today to transfer the containings of these cylinders onto modern media. Such cylinders were played on phonographs, vintage machines. The groove which is on the cylinder is contains the sound. So when the cylinder rotates, a needle can read the sound, it vibrates a membrane and a horn. This procedure to reproduce the sound is very harmful for such things because, being of wax, they are very, very fragile. Each audition of a cylinder onto a vintage phonograph adds background noise and other defaults. So I designed this machine in order to play cylinders with a minimum of contact. I baptized this archaeophone because it's a phonograph for archival purposes. A vintage machine plays a cylinder, and the stylus on the groove gives a force onto the groove, which is equivalent to something like 50 grams. 50 grams concentrated on the surface of the needle. I obtain here a good tracking with 2 or 3 grams only. Another interesting thing is that sound is directly transformed into electricity, which is not the case with vintage machines. Having a microphone in front of the horn of a vintage machine gives you an undesirable sound, like the noise of the clockwork motor of the phonograph, like the proper vibration of the horn, and even the reverberation of the room. So the cylinder is installed onto a mandrel, similar to the vintage machine mandrel, and then the turn arm will be in contact with the groove, and while the cylinder is rotating, the turn arm is going to follow the groove. Of course, the machine works with external recorders, amplifiers, etc. Speed is a matter of difficulty because each brand had their own speeds and were not reliable from a cylinder to another. Some of the cylinders were cracked, sometimes broken into different parts, or only with a hair crack or a little chip on an edge. And that way the cylinder is fragile, of course, and if I put it on the mandrel it will crack more, especially as it has to be put in force. If I force on a crack, I will open it, which will translate it into pock, 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 undesirable sound. That is why I made use of sellotape.
Bagpipes all over the turnpike, played by James D. McAuliffe.